And to give us an update on the investigation of the ambush of Hingoog Misamis Oriental Mayor Ruthie Guingona, we're joined on the line by Eastern Mindanao Command Head Major General Ricardo Rainier Cruz. Good afternoon, Major Cruz.
Good afternoon,
General Cruz. Yes. General. Yes. Sir, what is the latest information that you can give us about the investigation of to the ambush? What is the latest information you can give us in relation to the ambush of Mayor Guingona?
The latest update is that it was accepted by the CPP NDF that the ambush was there on the wings. 2 days ago, there was a massive military operation in the area resulting to an encounter with the said group.
Mm-hmm. And what can you tell us about the encounter that took place?
The military conducted a massive military operation in the vicinity of the hinterlands of Long City, and that they were able to encounter the group that ambushed Mayor Guingona.
Sir, how do they know that it's the same group that ambushed Mayor Guingona?
Based on a report, there's only one group operating in the area. That's the group of the MPA's guerrilla front 4B.
So it was...
It's only one group.
It couldn't have been any other members of the NPA that were operating in that area. It's really just those people, that group.
That area is allegedly under the guerrilla front 4B of the CPP NDF.
Okay. And sir, what happened to the those NPA rebels who were in that area? Were they injured? Were they where are they now? Are there any fatalities?
There was no fatalities that resulted in the encounter, but the army were. Army personnel were able to recover several ammunition and several war materials from the encounter site.
But none of them were captured?
No MPs were captured in the encounter.
And what happens next, sir?
Excuse me?
What will happen next? Are there continuing operations in the area in order to capture these people behind the ambush?
We will send more troops in the area to really run after those responsible for the ambush of Mayor Guingona.
Okay. General, the President has given an instruction, an order for law enforcement authorities to protect the candidates who are campaigning in non-NPA areas. But, sir, this is this practice of getting permits and paying donations or revolutionary taxes. This has been going on for a very long time now in certain areas. So what really can authorities do in order to stop this practice?
These NPA groups, as part of their so-called extortion activity, they resort to this extortion activity, taking advantage of the election campaign period. They know that these politicians will campaign in the hinterlands or in the far-flung barangays of their area. So they take advantage of this situation, and for those candidates whom they think are not conforming to their demands, they resort to this terroristic attacks. What they did to Mayor Guingona, they deliberately conducted this roadblock to really target their convoy.
So
deliberate attack on the convoy of Mayor Guingona.
Sir, so which brings me back to my question, how can we put a stop to this? Because whether or not there are elections, the NPA does conduct extortion activities. And so now that there is this directive from the president, how can you put a stop to this? How can law enforcement authorities put a stop to these extortion activities?
We've been conducting massive military operations in known NPA layers or known guerrilla bases of this NPA. Mm-hmm. But sometimes we cannot provide area security or security to all areas. So what we did, what we are doing now is we require politicians to give us in advance or days before their planned activities so that the military and the police, the PNP, can provide area security to politicians.
Mm-hmm. Sir, how important is it for the civilians and the candidates to cooperate in this effort to put a stop to the NPA's extortion activities?
I think that's a very good point. The civilians now are really very helpful in curbing this extortion activity. In line with the military's bayanihan team operations, we are now in a joint effort with the civilians, or not only the civilians, but all stakeholders in the community to stop these violent activities being conducted by the CPP, NPA, and the NDF. So yung tinatawag natin whole of nation approach, yun ang ginagawa natin to finally stop this violent activities by the CPP, NPA, and the NDF.
General, but do you think that for as long as candidates or even civilians keep paying the NPA protection money or keep paying for these campaign permits, this is not going to stop, is it? It's just going to fuel this whole cycle.
No, I think the politicians should not pay any revolutionary
exactly.
or extortion activity to the NPA.
Right. They have to stop for this cycle to stop.
Yeah, they have to stop or they should not pay or they should not feed into the extortion activity of the CPP, NPA, and the NDF. The more they give, I think the more the organization will grow. So it is a futile effort to we will continue to feed into the demands of the NPA.
Mm-hmm. And sir, earlier you said also that there is going to be a reinforcement of troops. How soon is that going to happen?
There are already some movements of troops in the area. We have plans to move in one Marine battalion in the area.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and what are the specific areas under your command, sir, which are considered hot spots?
Almost all the hinterlands of the northern Mindanao area, parts of Misamis, Agusta Norte and Surigao Norte, and parts of Misamis Oriental are considered hotspots. Mm-hmm. Only hinterlands, only mm-hmm. hinterlands.
Mm-hmm. Do you think, sir, that these areas should be declared under COMELEC control? Is there going to be a recommendation from your office for these areas to be put under COMELEC control for the upcoming elections?
Not really. These are not both rich areas, but these are areas which we consider as areas influenced by the NPA. So there's no need to take it under COMELEC control.
Okay. General Cruz, thank you very much for joining us this afternoon.